Hello, welcome to Space Engineers on the Xbox. This is my Pertum beta save, and this is a very short look at safe zones. Say hello to the safe zone. These things are extremely useful, but they require a lot of power. As you can see from this one, this one safe zone projects a 60 meter field, and to run it effectively I need three small large grid nuclear reactors connected to the grid. Two won't cut it, and the field will not show as active, but it is active and it's protecting the grid. You'll see another one in the distance there that's protecting my base, and as if luck would have it, a meteor storm is incoming. The good news with safe zones is they will protect against this kind of damage as long as the correct settings are enabled. Some of my base defense guns are acting against this incoming meteor storm. You'll see a meteor bouncing off the safe zone in the distance there. You can see our safe zone projecting a hexagon texture. I'll have a look at the control panel of the safe zone in a minute, but I think that's the meteor storm over. Right. Let's just do one thing. Let's shift the time of day. Right. Safe zone. First thing with a safe zone, you're going to need zone chips. Safe zones have two ports. They have one underneath, one at the back. Now, in here, you're going to stuff your zone chips. Zone chips cannot be manufactured. They can be summoned in using the spawn menu by an admin, or they can be bought from NPC trading stations. You know, those neutral white ones and so on, you'll see. You often get one when you arrive on your drop pod. You'll find the coordinates on a data pad in your passenger seat. Anyway, a safe zone control panel looks like this. And what you want to look at is they can only be enabled on stations. Now, some people use them on mobile grids and lock that grid down into a station. What we're looking at is, to enable the safe zone, you're going to need zone chips in that conveyor or in a container attached to it. And then you want to look at this first menu here. Allow damage, shooting, drilling, welding, grinding, building, and so on. All this stuff. If you allow it, it can happen. So if you allow drilling, somebody could drill under your safe zone to get in. Or just damage your base. However, as you can see, I can't do anything in this safe zone, but I can activate the welder. If I turn off welding, then we won't be able to weld any longer. What you want to know though about a safe zone is when you are going to activate it, ensure a couple of things are set. Go into your configure filter menu and have a look. You'll see there's a list of entities and players that can be allowed in. This should be default. It should allow you in automatically. What might not be default on the whitelist, remember there's a whitelist and blacklist. Whitelist will allow things, blacklist will prevent them. Hold on, I'm just coming out of this to see if this meteor storm attempts to wreck the base. That's coming in at this angle. It's a large one, so it might hit if it makes it past the defense guns. Go pinging off the shield of the safe zone. No more worries about meteors striking your base. Anyway, back to the configure menu. As I was saying, you want to look through the filters, players, grids and floating objects. What you want to look at is factions, and you want yourself to have your own faction. You want to add your own faction, because when you bring a vehicle in, it will belong to that faction. What happens if you bring a vehicle in that doesn't belong to that faction, or if you're a player that doesn't belong to the faction inside a safe zone when the safe zone activates? Well, let's bring in one of my little blueprints. Pop it down. Where do I want to put it? Here. And what we're going to do is we're going to give the grid to no one. So, open up the inventory menu, go to the control panel, select a block, hold down both bumpers, tap A twice, and you'll select everything. Then simply move across using the left stick. Remember the rule, left stick to go from window to window, D-pad to move between these submenus. We want to give this whole grid to nobody. Bye. See ya. Gone. That's what's going to happen to all of your ships, all of your things, if you don't configure your safe zone properly. So before you even add zone chips and enable the safe zone, you want to make sure straight away that you go to your configure filter menu, hit factions and add your own faction to that safe zone, plus anyone you may be friends with. Otherwise, they're going to have a horrible surprise when your safe zone activates, and so are you. Safe zones, as I said, can be used to prevent players, objects, you name it, from entering the grid. They're most often used for protecting on dedicated servers for offline damage to your grid when another player comes along and decides to wreck it. But they can be used in survival on a solo or hosted game to protect the grid from meteor storms and weather. So things like Pertum's vicious electric storms with the lightning. Here's my little special drone protection when you don't have a safe zone, but we'll talk about that sometime. It uses a mod which is the deployable shield wall. SE modder 4 put that up onto mod.io and it's pretty cool. Actually, I will just show you. When you press the button, it deploys one block into a grid of 3x3. That grid there is completely and utterly impervious to damage. So if I didn't have a safe zone running, nothing could get through that grid to harm this decoy below. Decoys can be used to attract lightning. Actually, just thinking about that might work. Best way to do it. This won't cause any damage either because we have a safe zone running. I'll talk about safe zones in a little bit, but first of all, let's just briefly see if we can't get a lightning strike or two. By bringing in a famous Pertum dust storm. Lightning is extremely vicious in this game, but with a safe zone running, you are actually protected from it. Without a safe zone running though, lightning can cause severe damage. So if you do have a decoy or a decoy tower set up, lightning will always strike decoys and antennas before it strikes anything else. Now, if I go into here, I just briefly disable this safe zone. Pull the zone chips out as well. So when you've built your safe zone, like lightning doesn't want to play. Oh, there's the lightning striking the one with the mod on. You can see that in action, and if you look at these plates, they don't actually have any damage whatsoever because they don't really seem to exist as objects that can be damaged. Okay, I'm going to let this lightning storm rage while I talk more about this safe zone. So when you've got a safe zone like this and you enable it like this, you have a small amount of time before it kicks in, but it needs zone chips. So until it's got zone chips, it's going to look like this. And if you don't have enough power when you've got zone chips in there, it's going to look like this as well. Before you enable it, make sure you've set it up, make sure you've got everything, including your filter, configured. And all you need to do is, before it reaches the end of its cycle, get enough zone chips. It consumes one every hour of operation. Boop. 113 seconds left before it activates. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. Take that grid out. You should just leave this decoy sitting there. And this decoy will get struck by lightning at some point. In the next few minutes, should do. Again, I've got other videos where I've shown the lightning towers in action, so you know this trick works. And what a safe zone will do is protect you against it without needing to use the lightning towers at all. You don't even need a lightning tower, you could just leave your safe zone up. Any lightning that strikes in the area will cause no damage, as long as you have the no damage setting enabled on the safe zone. Oh, that hit me, but it didn't cause any damage. 27 seconds to go. I mean, it couldn't cause any damage anyway, but nice to see. Seeing the safe zone, there it is. All its glory. Active. Doing his job. Protecting everything. From the riggers, the meteor storms, and vicious weather. Lightning storms on Earth, etc., etc. And there you go, you've just seen a lightning strike hit the decoy, and no damage. Thanks to the safe zone. And just for the finale, full-on Pertum electric storm combined with a meteor strike. I say, bear in mind again, safe zones work on stations. Safe zones have to be configured. If you don't have the correct configuration when you activate it, that vehicle there is going bye-bye. It will fly off into the wild blue yonder. Cargo truck. Bye. That's a basic intro to safe zones. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. Hopefully it's given you an idea, shown you the rudimentary elements of a safe zone, how safe zones protect you. Until the next one, stay safe, take care, have fun, happy engineering. I'll catch you again. Hydrogen rebalance video incoming, and it is the next video. Bye for now.